Yes, ma'am.
How are you?
Fine.
Yeah. Are you ready to learn?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. All of you, please switch on your cameras. Minha, Abin, Elna, Rose, Anandu, Dominic, Bastin, Elsa, Devasena. So let's recall the points that we learned in the last class, okay? So which are the two laws of combination, Adulya?
Yes, ma'am. Law of conservation of mass and law of constant proportion.
Yeah, very good. Law of conservation of mass and law of constant proportion. Then Amarin. Amarin, please unmute. Switch on your camera.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Who introduced the law of constant proportion?
His name. Ma'am, I forgot his name.
Gauri, do you remember?
Joseph L. Proust.
Yeah, Joseph L. Proust. Amarin?
Yes, ma'am.
Who introduced?
Joseph L. Proust.
Joseph L. Proust. Okay. Then, atomic radius is measured in which unit, Dominic? Dominic, unmute. Are you there? Dominic? All of you, please switch on your cameras. Otherwise, I will mark you as absent. Shania? All of you, please switch on your cameras. Okay? Yeah. Dominic, Bastin, Elsa, Devasena, Shania, Ahlam, Fatima, Sean, all of you switch on your cameras. Yeah, Revu.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, atomic radius is measured in which unit?
No.
Which one?
Nano.
Yeah, nano.
Nanometer.
Yeah, nanometer. Then which are the two laws that we discussed in the last class? Sovel?
Law of constant proportion.
Yeah, law of constant proportion. There is one more law. What is that? Sovel, are you there? Yeah, law of cons. That related to mass. Okay, Srihari, can you help him?
Law of conservation of mass.
Okay, so well, which are the two laws?
Law of conservation of mass and law of constant proportion.
Okay, very good. Then, Elna Rose, please unmute.
Put on your videos, Mina. Lakshmi, Dominic, Sean, Alam, Minha, Dominic, do you have any problem? Please tell the teacher.
So, Elna, who introduced the law of constant proportion? Please unmute.
Joseph Proust.
Yeah, Joseph L. Proust. Okay. Then in the last class, I just mentioned about how the symbols and elements came. The name of symbols and elements came, right? Today we are going to learn more about how the elements and symbols came. Okay? So, is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So, in the beginning, the names of the elements were derived from the name of the place where they were found for the first time. Okay, in the beginning, the names of the elements were derived from the name of the place where they found it for the first time. Clear? Is it clear? Yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So, example, copper. The element copper was taken from the name Cyprus. Okay? Cyprus. It is a place where it was found for the first time. Okay? The place from where it was found for the first time. So, copper, it is derived from the name Cyprus. That is a place where it is found for the first time. Clear? Is it clear, Revu?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. That's the first point. Then the second point, some names of the elements were taken from specific colors. Some names of the elements were taken from specific colors. Example, gold. Okay. Gold is an element, right? So it is taken from the English word meaning yellow. Okay, here gold is derived from the word meaning yellow. Okay, so some names were taken from specific colors. Elements, names of such elements were taken from specific colors. So example, gold. It is the word meaning yellow. Okay, and now IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Okay, that's the full form of IUPAC. Clear? IUPAC. International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry approves the names of elements. I told you that there are more than 100 elements, right? So, and new elements are discovered. And new elements will be discovered. All the names of these elements are approved by IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Shania? Yeah, what's the full form of IUPAC?
International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry.
Yeah, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Okay, then we are going to learn how the symbols of the elements came. Okay, how the symbols of element scheme. Many of the symbols are the first one or two letters of the elements. Okay? Many of the symbols are the first one or two letters of the element's name itself. Clear? Example. What about the symbol of hydrogen? Anjali Priya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, what's the symbol of hydrogen? Do you have any idea?
In a circle, there is a small dot.
That's the symbol proposed by Dalton. This is the new method of representing the symbols of elements. Do you have any idea about the new type of symbols?
No, ma'am.
Yeah, so the hydrogen, it is represented as H. H for hydrogen. So it is the first letter of that element's name, right? That is mentioned here. Many of the symbols are the first one or two letters of the element's name in English. H for hydrogen. Then what about oxygen, Gauri? Oxygen.
O. What?
Yeah, O. O for oxygen. Okay. Then I will ask another question. Geraldine, do you know the symbol of aluminium?
A. AL.
AL, very good. AL. Here we take the first two letters, right? In the case of hydrogen and oxygen, we take the first letter of that element. But in the case of certain other elements, we are taking the first two letters, A and L. Is it clear? Is it clear for everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So, Lakshmi Nanda.
Yes, ma'am.
Who approved the symbols of elements? Which organization? Yeah, you forgot. Okay, Elsa.
Ma'am.
Who approved the names of elements? Which organization approved the names of elements of the periodic table?
IUPAC.
No, IUPAC. Mm-hmm. Wait. IUPAC. Okay. International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Okay. IUPAC is the abbreviation of International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So, say it once again. Which organization approved the names of elements in the periodic table, Minha?
International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry.
Yeah. What's the short form?
IUPAC.
Yeah, IUPAC. Clear. And we learned that the names of the elements even derived from the place where it was found. Then next one, it is from colors, right? Then the symbols of elements always written in the form of the first letter or the first two letters of the element. Clear? Is it clear? Yeah. Then... the representation of symbols, how we represent the symbol. The first letter of a symbol is always written as capital letter, okay? The first letter of the symbol always written as capital letter, that is in uppercase. And the second letter as a small letter, that is in lowercase. So when we represent symbols of elements, the first letter should be represented as capital letter, that is in uppercase, and the second letter should be represented as small letter. When we look at this example, hydrogen. Here it is represented as capital H, right? It is represented as capital H. And in the case of aluminium, it is AL. The first letter A is represented as capital and the next letter L is represented as small letter, right? Yeah, then the next example, cobalt. Okay, cobalt. The first letter C is represented as capital letter. Then the second letter O is represented as small letter. Clear? If there is only one letter, it is represented as capital. If there are two letters as symbols, first letter as capital letter and the second letter as small letter. Is this clear, Justin? Justin, can you hear
me? Ma'am.
Yeah, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Then the next one. The symbols of some elements, symbols for some elements are formed from the first letter of the name and a letter appearing later in the name. Okay. First letter is the name of the element itself, but the second letter is appearing later in the name. That means when we pronounce chlorine, okay, chlorine, the first letter C that we take, then chlo, L is pronounced, right? L is pronounced, so we take L as the second letter. Cl. Okay, Cl. Clear? Then look at this another example. Zinc. When we pronounce zinc, Z, Z, then N, right? Z, zinc. So we take Z and N as symbols. Here also the first letter is represented as capital letter and the second letter is represented as small letter. Clear? Geraldine, clear? Is it clear for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Then some other symbols have been taken from the names of elements in Latin, German, or Greek. Okay. Some other symbols have been taken from the names of elements in Latin, German, or Greek. For example, do you know the symbol of iron?
Fe.
Fe.
Yeah, very good. Fe. So this Fe, it was derived from the Latin name ferrum. Okay, iron, its Latin name is ferrum. So we take the symbol Fe from its Latin name itself. Then we look at this example, sodium. Okay, sodium. What's the symbol of sodium?
Na. Let's,
yeah, Na. Okay, fine. Na. This Na is also derived from the Latin word natrium. Okay, sodium is pronounced sodium in Latin name, it is pronounced as natrium. So we take the symbol Na. Then another example, potassium. It is derived from the Latin word kalium. Okay, kalium. So we take the symbol K. Kalium, K. Clear? So iron Fe, that is from ferrum. Then sodium Na, that is natrium. Then potassium K, kalium. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Any doubt? So Lakshmi, not Lakshmi, wait. Anandu Krishna.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you read this slide once again?
The first letter of a symbol is always written as a capital letter.
Yeah.
And the second letter as a smaller letter.
Okay, second letter as a small letter. Then?
For example, hydrogen, yeah, is known as H.
Yeah, symbol of hydrogen is H. Then?
Aluminium.
Yeah.
Is known as Al.
Yeah, symbol of aluminium is Al.
And cobalt.
Cobalt. Okay, cobalt. Yeah, symbol of cobalt is?
CO.
Yeah, CO. Okay, then Elsa. Read the second one. Read the second one.
Symbols for some elements are formed from the first letter of the name and a letter appearing later in the name.
Okay.
Chlorine, Cl. Zinc,
yeah. SL. Zinc?
Zn.
Yeah, Zn. Okay. Then, Sania?
Yes, ma'am.
Read the next point.
Some other symbols have been taken from the names of elements in Latin, German, or Greek.
Yeah.
For example, Fe from its Latin name ferrum.
Yeah.
Sodium is Na from natrium.
Natrium.
And potassium is natrium, and potassium is K from kalium.
Yeah, kalium. So therefore, each element in the periodic table has a unique name and a unique chemical symbol. Okay, each element in the periodic table has a unique name and unique chemical symbol. Clear? Then I will show you certain examples of elements and their symbols. There are more examples in the in your textbook, page number 34. Okay, after the class you just go through that. Here Ashik, are you there?
Yes.
Yeah, please read this elements and symbols. All of you, please switch on your cameras. Yeah, Ashik.
Aluminium.
Yeah.
Aluminium. Air.
Aluminium symbol is Al. Then.
Argon. Ar. Yeah.
Argon. Ar.
Barium.
Barium. Barium.
Barium.
Yeah.
Ba.
Ba.
Calcium. Ca. Okay.
Calcium. Ca.
Carbon. C.
Carbon. C.
Chlorine. C. Cl.
Yeah. Chlorine. Cl.
Cobalt.
Cobalt.
Cobalt. Co.
Yeah. Cobalt. Co.
Copper. Cu.
Copper. Cu.
Fluorine. F.
Yeah. Fluorine. F.
Gold. Au.
Gold. Au.
Hydrogen. H.
Hydrogen. H. Okay. Wait. Devasena. Devasena, are you there? Devasena, can you hear me? Okay, Karthik. Karthik, unmute. Karthik. No response. Okay, Anthony. Anthony.
Respond, respond. Why are you silent?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Anthony, read the remaining.
They are not responding. Mark them absent.
Yes, sir. Okay. Okay, Anthony, read the remaining.
Iodine.
Yeah, first one, iodine. Yeah, iodine.
I see, Joshi, what picture have you put?
Is this symbols clear for you? Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, then read from the remaining.
I-N-F-E.
Iodine, I. I-N-F-E, okay. Then?
Lead.
Lead. PB.
Nitrogen N.
Nitrogen N.
Oxygen O.
Oxygen O.
Ashik Joshi, you have put the same picture. I don't want to see that.
Sir, my video is on.
But you have put some other picture. Profile. If your video is not on, it's okay.
Yeah. So continue, Anthony.
Potassium K.
Potassium K.
Silicon Si.
Silicon Si.
Silver Ag.
Silver Ag.
Sulfur S.
Sulfur S.
Zinc ZN.
Zinc ZN. Okay. So these all are the elements and symbols. Okay. So by practicing, and we are using these elements and symbols throughout our chemistry. So by more practice, you all are more familiar with these terms. This is just to familiarize how the symbols and elements represented in a periodic table. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So, wait, Gauri.
Yes, ma'am.
What's the symbol of sodium? Do you remember? Sodium.
Ma'am, C.
Sodium. Shania, Gauri, wait. Shania, do you remember? No, it's okay. By more practicing, you all are familiar with this symbols. Yeah, very good. Na. Okay, elements and symbols. There is a table in your textbook 34. Please go through that after the class, okay? Elements, symbols. And more practicing, you all are very much fluent in this elements and symbols. Okay? Don't worry, okay? So, then we are going to learn about atomic masses. Do you heard that term before? Do you remember the postulates of Dalton's atomic theory? Postulates of Dalton's atomic theory. Srihari, do you remember the 6 postulates? Do you remember, yes or no?
No, ma'am.
No. There are 6 postulates, right? You should study it well. One of the postulates stated that there is an atomic mass. Okay, there is atomic mass for every element. Okay, there is atomic mass for every element. So we are going to learn what do you mean by this atomic mass. Okay. So Dalton's atomic theory proposed the idea of atomic mass. Dalton's atomic theory proposed the idea of atomic mass, which explains the law of constant proportion. Do you remember the law of constant proportion? Geraldine? Geraldine?
Yes, ma'am.
What do you mean by the law of constant proportion?
During a chemical reaction, the total mass of reactants will be equal to the total mass of...
That is the law of conservation of mass, okay? The law of constant proportion state that the elements in the compound should be in a fixed proportion or fixed ratio. Do you remember the example of H2O?
Yes, ma'am. 1 by 8.
Yeah, very good. 1 by 8. That is the proportion. 1:8. So that's the law of constant proportion. So this atomic mass is explained well in Dalton's atomic theory as well as the law of constant proportions. Then what do you mean by this atomic mass? The mass of an atom of an element is called its atomic mass. The mass of an atom of an element is called its atomic mass. The mass of an atom of an element is called its atomic mass. Then determining the mass of an individual atom was a relatively difficult task. Okay. Determining the mass. I told you that there are more than 100 elements, right? So it is very difficult to determining the mass of individual atom. So we used a technique that is relative atomic mass. Relative atomic mass was determined. How we determine the mass by relative atomic mass? Here we are using a reference, okay? Here we are using the reference, and using that reference we are going to find out the atomic masses of other elements. Okay, a standard reference of a mass will be taken, and then we compare all other masses with that reference. In this way we are find out the atomic masses of different elements. And the atomic mass unit, it is abbreviated as AMU, atomic mass unit. The atomic mass is expressed in terms of atomic mass unit, and it is abbreviated as AMU in earlier times, and now it is written as unified mass. Okay, unified mass, that is U. Now it is represented as unified mass. So well, unmute. Yes, yeah, read these points once again.
Atomic mass. Dalton's atomic theory proposed the idea of atomic mass, which explained the law of constant proportion so well.
Yeah.
The mass of an atom of an element is called atomic mass.
Yeah, the mass of an atom of an element is called its atomic mass. Okay, continue.
Determining the mass of individual atoms was a relatively difficult task. Related atomic mass was determined.
Yeah, the atomic masses of elements was elements are found out by using the technique relative atomic mass. Okay, read.
Atomic mass mass unit abbreviated as AMU, earlier now written as unit mass.
Unified mass U. Okay, unified mass U. So atomic mass unit abbreviated as AMU earlier, now it is written as unified mass. Okay, so Sania, what do you mean by atomic mass?
Yes, ma'am. The mass of the atom of an element is called the atomic mass.
Yeah, the mass of an atom of its element is called its atomic mass. Which is the unit that we used earlier for this atomic mass? Sean, unmute. Yeah, which unit? Which one?
Can you repeat?
Yeah, yeah. Which unit that we used to determine the atomic mass earlier? Which is the unit? Yeah. It is unified mass. That's now. What about earlier times?
AMU.
Yeah, AMU. What is the full form of AMU? Full form? Bastin, what's the full form of AMU?
Atomic mass unit.
Yeah, atomic mass unit. So, AMU, atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit. The atomic mass is expressed in terms of AMU, atomic mass unit. That is earlier times. And now it is U, that is unified mass. Unified mass. Okay? Clear? Is it clear, Minha?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So today we learned how the symbols of elements are represented, and we learned about atomic mass, right? Then there is one more class, right? We can learn the continuation of this atomic mass in this in that class. Okay. Melita, can you hear me? Melita, can you hear me? No? Yes. So what's the unit of atomic mass? Melita, what's the unit of atomic mass? If there is any network problem. Yeah, it's okay, Melita. I read your message. Okay, wait. Emerin, what's the unit of atomic mass? Emerin, unmute. Emerin, unmute.
Anu.
Yeah, unit of atomic mass.
Anu.
Which one?
Abbreviated.
Yeah, AMU, okay. AMU, atomic mass unit. Clear? Then, which unit we use nowadays for determining the atomic mass, Gaudi?
Unified mass.
Unified mass, U. And which organization approved the symbols of elements, Sania?
IUPAC.
Yeah, IUPAC. What's the full form of IUPAC, Gerlin?
The National Union of Pure and Applied.
Yeah, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. What is the symbol of potassium, Srihari? Do you remember potassium?
MK.
Yeah, very good. K, calcium. And what's the symbol of iron, Anjali Priya?
I.
Which one?
I.
Iron. No.
Fe.
Fe. That is from ferrum, right? Then what's the symbol of zinc? Elsa, zinc.
Zn.
Zn. Okay, very good. So you should keep practicing these elements and their symbols. Then you will be very much fluent in symbols and their elements. Okay. So let's take your attendance. Abin Thompson.
Present, ma'am.
Ahlam Fatima.
Present, ma'am.
Alna Rose.
Present, ma'am.
Ananda Krishna. Ananda Krishna. I think he was there. Okay. Anjali Priya.
Present, ma'am.
Anthony Maxi.
Present, ma'am.
Yeah. Arun Bhaskar. Arun. Ashik Joshi.
Present, ma'am.
Adulya.
Present, ma'am.
Bastin Joy.
Present, ma'am.
Devasena.
Present.
Dominic Anthony. Dominic, yeah. Elsa Babu.
Present, ma'am.
Emerin.
Present, ma'am.
Fagat. No. Gauri Nandana.
Present, ma'am.
Gautam. Gautam? No? Okay, Jerlyn?
Present, ma'am.
Jesslyn? Jesslyn? Okay, Arun. Jesslyn? No. Joel? Joel? Justin?
Present, ma'am.
Karthik?
Present, ma'am.
Shetra? Shetra. Lakshmi Nanda. Melita. Melita. Yeah, Melita, okay. Minha.
Present, ma'am.
Revu.
Present, ma'am.
Sania.
Present, ma'am.
Shania.
Present, ma'am.
Sean.
Present, ma'am.
Sovel.
Present, ma'am.
Sriram. Sriram. No. Sri Hari.
Present, ma'am.
Swadi Krishna. Swadi Krishna. No. Okay. So, just read that elements and symbols for the next class, okay? So, see you in next class. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.